Send down that cloud with the silver lining. Lift me to paradise.
Well, that was
wonderful.
Hideous. Wait, what?
That was amazing.
How can you say that?
What do you mean?
I have been a member of the Columbia House Singers for 4 years now, and that was, without question, the very worst.
Oh, please.
Did you see the way he was going on? It's like we weren't even there.
Well, it's not exactly like he needs us.
The way he was interjecting those little musical comments over the choral parts?
It was like a call and response. I thought it was funny.
It's not funny.
The band seemed to think it was funny.
The band? Don't even let me get started on the band. They're as bad as he is.
How can you say that? They've played Carnegie Hall.
Well, there's no accounting for taste. Come on, you know how those people are.
What people?
Those people, you know.
No, I really don't.
Look, all I'm saying is they are very lucky that they've been given an opportunity to record with Columbia Records at all.
But
so to waste all of our time with their constant hijinks and their smoke breaks,
they're enjoying themselves. They're having a good time.
Well, I'm not. It's unprofessional.
I think you're being a little harsh.
How would you describe it?
I would describe it as a talented... A very talented group of musicians who haven't played together in a very long time, coming together to record an album and maybe remembering why they came together in the first place.
And what's that?
Joy? Excitement? Passion?
Reefer!
Andy!
They're all hopheads. Come on, you can smell it on them.
Oh, it doesn't make any difference.
Yes, it does. The president of this label is investing a lot of time and money in this record, and they don't even have the decency to leave their filthy habits back in the ghetto where they belong.
Oh my God.
So instead of respecting the opportunity they are being given and the implicit trust being placed in them by the leader of one of the most important record labels in the world, they spend the whole morning goofing off, improvising, and openly mocking the contributions of the Columbia House Singers, which, let's face it, are this album's only chance of any kind of mainstream success. And then, on top of all of that, we have to spend the last half hour listening to their leader, this supposed giant in the quote-unquote jazz scene, make nonsense sounds with his mouth.
It's called scatting.
It's just noise.
It's an art form.
It's gibberish.
It requires a level of musicality most singers can only ever hope to achieve.
To be able to improvise rhythm and melodies with just your voice...
Musicality. Musicality.
You think that gives them some kind of musicality? Frank Sinatra. Dean Martin, Vic Damone, those are singers. This is just baby talk.
Don't do that. Just don't.
Do what?
Reduce something you don't understand to childishness. There is an entire culture and history here that you don't know anything about, so you feel free to go ahead and dismiss it as baby talk.
You're right. It's not baby talk.
Thank you.
It's more like baby shit.
Shut up.
What?
I said shut up.
You can't talk to me that way.
Yes, I can, and I will.
I have been a member of the Columbia House Singers for 4 years now. You've only been here a year.
Yes, and you know, I don't think I can stand to be here for another minute.
What?
You heard me. I am tired of providing bland backup vocals for artists who are far too talented to need them in the hopes that some small-minded bigots like you might actually deign to listen to their music that they don't even deserve to hear, much less can ever even hope to appreciate.
What are you saying?
So I will have to stay right here with 2, 4, 3.
I quit.
Here she comes.
Gung, 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 gung,